is Allie. I am a boudoir model and a recent addition to the FMyLife cast. Today I'm going to be reviewing some of these comments left on episode Quickie 20, Shitcanned, which is my most popular and notoriously known episode. So I guess let's get to it. All right. She looks like Nora Allen from The Flash, and she's hot as fuck. First of all, I know exactly who you're talking about. Second of all, she is hot as fuck. And third, that's already the nicest thing anybody said in this comment section, and it's the first comment. So, good job to Snazzerwolf. The second comment says, the look on her face when her boss opened the door had me dying. Then leaving the bag of shit, lol, if they do a part three, she's gonna end up on the unemployment line, from Jeremy Smith. That's actually a really funny, idea, and I wouldn't mind doing a part three to the whole story, because from the get-go, it was so funny. We started off doing the first Quickie part to it, and then mid-filming that, Wyatt had this awesome idea about, hey, so I have this other skit that's kind of an addition. I don't know if you're not willing to do it, it's fine, but I read it. It was so funny. We were already dying laughing the whole time filming the first one that it just made sense, and it was awesome. But a part three would be so fun, and you might be onto something there. Albert Stinnett says, I would love to pound that butt with three... likes on that. Thank you. I think. Thank you. from Robert McGinn. Sorry if I'm pronouncing everybody's names wrong. Just sorry. Did you take inspiration from Van Wilder or Never Going Back? I've never seen Never Going Back. I wanted to. I think it came out a few years ago, and it looked funny. But I have seen plenty of Van Wilder, and I could definitely say Van Wilder, a little Dumb and Dumber, were the inspiration behind the acting for pooping in the trash can. Tomas Alberto, I'm very sad because you had not finished pooping. I was very sad too. It was unfortunate. Burrito Barn, man. The WWE guy, 2K17, says, more please, and you got it. You got it, dude. Definitely more in the future. Another one from Tomas says, in the trash, but nobody saw you. You're right. I didn't get to finish pooping in the trash. Who knows? There's always that part three. Another one from Robert McKinn. Where do you get the peeing, pooping, and farting sound effects? And can you give a link, please? Well, that's all the technical side. I do just the improv acting part of it. But the website that they use is freesounds.org. And I'll put a link in the description for you guys if you guys want to find it and use it for your own videos. I think it's super funny. But yeah, so we'll put the link, below. Solomon Welch says, make more of these. Again, you got it. I'm totally down for it. I love how these have come out. I'm even okay being known as the girl who pooped in the trash can. It's all good to me, so, definitely more in the future. Another one, from Jacob Sacringius. Cute name, bad. Don't know how to pronounce it. Saying more of this girl. Again, you guys got it. Like, ask and thou shall receive. Again, from Austin Escalera. Please, Alyxandria, make more with you. I will be doing it. Real quick, though, Alyxandria's with a Y, not an E. I have to be a little extra. I have to stand out just a little bit, right? So, Tomas Alberto, which country do you live? United States. For better or for worse, United States. Guy Brown, it happens, Taco Bell. You're right. But in this case, it was Burrito Barn, and shirts are available, by the way. So go to the Notebook Movies page, and you can find links for that. And this one is just the... That one was just the little tag, and damn it. Okay. Touche, Mick plays Roblox. Touche. Jessie Quill, she's hot. I love you, babe. You're still cute. Thank you. You know, I think it's like a well-known phrase in the modeling industry that if you can poop in a trash bag and still look hot, you're onto something. So, you know. yeah. And then Chi Chi Sun said, I noticed you guys edited the thumbnails on all of the toilet videos. I'm guessing that had to do with it being inappropriate. Yeah. YouTube flags everything and spams everything. It's just awful. So we had to change the thumbnails because pooping in a toilet isn't community standards for any social media, I guess. So, Mo HD Khalid, or Mod Khalid, says, more videos, this girl. It's happening, like, I can't be in all of them, but I'll do my best to, like, you know, Where's Waldo it up for, you know, Carmen San Diego it up for you guys. Julian Tan says, so beautiful, I love you. You guys don't even know me. You guys don't love me. You love the idea of a girl who poops on camera in a toilet trash bag stuff thing. Like, no. No. But thank you. Reese Jeffrey asks, did it hurt? Like, is there the rest of the sentence somewhere? Like, did it hurt when you fell from heaven? Did it hurt when you almost shit your pants in front of your boss? It hurt my ego, really. Yo mama told me that you didn't wash your hands! Exclamation mark. They were very serious about that. I didn't, you're right, and my mama taught me better, so to be called out by yo mama, you're right. Another one from Reese is this one. Did it hurt? Is this one. And then there's another one by Reese. Is it true? Like, I feel like you're really philosophical and you're asking like the big Socrates questions right now. Is this one, did it hurt? Is it true? I don't fucking know. I don't. Danag Jidat says, are you pooping in a plastic bag for real?
Yes. It's part of my method acting. Like, I have to really be there. I really did eat the Burrito Barn. Extra avocado. And I really did poop with all of my heart and soul and passion for this channel. I pooped in that bag. So I could bring that Oscar home to you. But no. No.
Javier Bartolo says, perfecto. Muchas gracias. Thank you. Snazzerwolf. Why does everybody want to link it right back up to when I'm about to poop? Like the crescendo of the whole video. She's about to blow. There she blows. Like, I don't know. I don't get it. Hey You asks, what color were her panties?
I don't wear panties. That's why there are no colors of the panties. I'll even show you.
Hey there. No panties. Don't wear them. Don't need them. You guys talk about the butt a lot, but when you have a giant butt,
it's a giant vortex to, like, steal underwear in itself. It's awful. So, no underwear.
Let's see. Question mark from Esley.
I see your question mark and raise it an exclamation mark.
What now? Roly Poly Oly Fanatic 2019.
For one, that show is my childhood, so thank you for that.
Bring it back. They have to say Korean girls eat at the Burrito Barn.
They shouldn't. You've seen what happens. Nobody should eat at the Burrito Barn 2019. Hashtag.
MRLPN2. Her boss isn't a lesbian, is she? And then the response is, why does it matter? From Cameron Clark. And Steve Guzman says, LOL, I can't effing tell. Think it's a dude with a girl voice. Fun fact about that one, the person playing my boss is a lesbian. She's also my wife. Her name is Raven. You'll see her in quite a few Notebook movies as well, and skits. Definitely not a dude with a girl voice. I think it's more like the other way around. Girl with like a duder voice, but you know, I'm sure like a little clip of an Aerosmith song going on. You can put that in there, right?
Yeah.
About not. Okay. And then finally, we're at the end. Gerardo Jackson wants to know if you can be in the next video with me. If you don't live in the greater Chicago area, probably not, unfortunately. But that doesn't mean that you can't make your own skits and share them all over the internet so I can see you pooping in a trash bag instead. So I guess that's it. These comments were very interesting. I know some people left some others on some of the other videos, and I'll probably just go through those at a later time and respond to them on YouTube. So, you know, you might see me again pop up. But very interesting. I noticed there's a theme recurring. You guys love me. You guys want me to be in more videos. I have a very large butt. To name a few. But all in all, you guys are a great crowd, and this was really entertaining to read through. And I definitely think I got a takeaway from this, and it definitely wasn't any more Burrito Barn. But I guess I have two things to add at the very end of this, and I would say the first is, I want to know who the fuck raised half of you to say half of what's on there. And the other question I would say is, if you guys have any suggestions for more videos, more ideas that you want to see me do on the channel, more things that you want to see in general, please leave a comment below. Let us know. We feed off of that. If you guys want to see more of me in general, can't have me without the whole show, so visit the Patreon page and make sure you support the cause so I can keep doing this. And thanks again, you guys are awesome. Until next time.